2021 commencement ceremony. Katz, Hillel, please. What a crazy year it has been, and how good it is to be here in person with all of you this evening to celebrate. It is hard to believe that what seems like only yesterday, we returned to our beloved campus after almost 6 months of being apart. We are so incredibly grateful to Hashem for the success of this year, for the face-to-face learning, and the joy of being together with friends and colleagues. And here we are, at the end of this emotionally and spiritually demanding year, honoring this year's eighth grade. We made it. But before we get to our eighth graders, I would like to recognize our unbelievable faculty and staff. I'd ask you all to please stand. Faculty and staff, please rise. Faculty and staff. Sorry for the confusion there. But truly, we honor you this evening. I know that all of us here tonight realize how fortunate we are that our children have been able to learn from such dedicated educators who care passionately about their students' success. This past year and a half has thrown challenges at them that are unprecedented, and yet they gave everything of themselves, working insane hours because they believe in each of our students. Eighth graders, make sure that you remember what they have taught you as you venture forward in your lives. Make your teachers proud. I would like specifically to thank my leadership team, Hadassah Solarsik, Chaim Diamond, Rita Lanner, Joe Sharp, Suzanne Rice, my right hand, Jill Kamenevsky, for all their efforts in always striving for new heights for our students and our school, even during a pandemic. This year, I also extend my deepest gratitude directly to Nurse Robin, Julie Abrams, Rabbi Eisenberger, Risa Kahan, Karen Wongson, Janine Richards, and the entire maintenance team for their behind-the-scenes work that often gets unseen that enabled us to keep our school open this year for face-to-face learning as well as Zoom learning. I am also incredibly appreciative of Mora Hadassah, Mora Lanner, Jill Kamenevsky, and Roy Eisenberger, who helped pull this graduation night together. It was certainly no easy feat. And thank you as well to Mr. Solarsik for the amazing video that you will soon see. Additionally, I want to recognize our alumni who are here this evening. All alumni, take a stand, please. Everyone, alumni, please take a stand. Seats were limited, obviously, this year, but we're especially thrilled that you were able to be here tonight with us to celebrate with your families. There's yet another group of individuals who deserve immense gratitude for the work in our school. Our PTA, chaired by Rachel Harrow, who volunteered their time throughout this difficult year in creative ways to make our teachers feel appreciated and our families feel connected. Thank you. To Dan Katz and the entire KGS board, thank you for your dedication to our school and the hard work you put in to always strive to make our school even greater. I would like to pay special tribute this evening to those families whose last child is graduating from Katz Day School this year. Those families know who you are, please stand. We honor you for all that you have done for our school, the hours you have volunteered, the sacrifices you have made, and having enhanced our community by being a part of it. We hope that you will stay connected to our community, even though your children will be moving on. And finally, to all of our eighth grade parents for their commitment to Jewish education, your passion for our school. We thank you for leaving your children in our charge and entrusting us in helping them grow into the outstanding individuals whom we have before us this evening. But of course, tonight is specifically a night to recognize a group of students, some who have been at KHDS for as much as 12 years, some for fewer, but all who have devoted themselves to learn about Jewish values and tradition, Israel, its people and country, and about the world around them. It has been no easy task with the long days of hard work, especially this year. But today, they sit before us ready to begin the next phase of their lives. Eighth graders, this is to you. Kites rise highest against the wind, not with it. said Winston Churchill. You're well versed in challenges after this past year and a half. Use adversity to help you grow. Don't ever allow yourself to coast in life. As Rav Nachman of Breslov once said, if you are not a better person tomorrow than you are today, what need have you for a tomorrow? Human beings have the potential to imagine themselves as other than they are and have always been. Dream big, strive high. When discussing the Tower of Babel, the Netziv, in his Emek Dabar, suggested the sin of the builders was that the individual was nullified in the collective while in their building efforts. Their sin was uniformity. Pirkei Rabbi Eliezer writes, in building the Tower of Babel, a laborer who climbed the steps with bricks in hand, losing his footing, he would slip and fall to his death, shattering the bricks. In response, onlookers would sink into deep mourning for the valuable broken bricks, not for the expendable human life. They would then cry, woe is to us, when will we have another brick to replace it? In the city of Babel, the collective was everything. An individual was worth only as much as he or she contributed to the whole. Babel was coercively conformist society. It's not about faking it till you make it, but rather it's about being authentic self, your authentic self, and always striving to become the best version of that authentic self. It's not about the clothing you wear, the car you will one day drive, or the smartphone model that you have. Rather, it's about the person you are. Don't try to be someone else. Respect yourself. Believe in yourself. Be your number one cheerleader. But don't forget to do all of that with a sense of humility. One cannot have true kavod without a sense of anava. At the same time, Judaism believes strongly in the idea of kehilah, of community. If all you think about is your individuality, but not your community, what will our world become? Too often throughout this pandemic, we have seen individuals put their own personal interests ahead of their needs and safety of the community. Make sure that you always consider others' needs before your own. I came to KHDS as you were first entering middle school. And though we were both new to the middle school, it speaks so highly of all of you as a grade how you brought me on as your new head of school into the KHDS fold. For that, I thank all of you. You are an energetic bunch with such diverse personalities who together have created a dynamic grade, as was evident in this year's color board that we thankfully were able to have. I've enjoyed getting to know each of you. Remember to always let your individual personalities shine, while all the while being part of community. When you look back on your time at KHDS, I hope it will be one of fond memories and long-lasting friendships. But I also hope that the lessons that you have learned will carry forward in your lives, not only intellectually, but more importantly with the Jewish values that will, God willing, be a foundation for your entire life. It's now my honor to call upon Mr. Dan Katz, President of the Board of Trustees, who would like to share a few words.
Dear 8th graders and your families, on behalf of the Board of Trustees of Hillel Day School, I want to wish each graduate a sincere mazal tov and extend a sincere thank you to all your parents for entrusting us with your education. A huge yashar koach was Rabbi Kotak and his wonderful admin team, our devoted medical advisory boards, Drs. Leora Adler, Ben Friedman, and Todd Schlesinger, and every one of our teachers and staff at Hillel who went the extra 1,000 miles to keep us all safe and sane this school year. Believe it or not, when many schools were on virtual learning all year, we at Hillel were open every day. Please join me in giving all these wonderful people an applause and welcome. I also want to publicly thank Rabbi Kotak for the 3 years he has given us to guide our beloved school. Rabbi Kotak personifies the word mensch. He is always a mensch, always kind and considerate, and never loses his cool. He's always an amazing role model to all of us who have had the opportunity to interact with him. Rabbi Kotak, I know I speak on behalf of all our students, parents, and members of our Board of Trustees, that we all thank you for all your efforts and wish you a happy and healthy future. next year, and I'm sick about not going on our annual trip to Israel. I promise you I'll try to make it up to you. Stay tuned. Just be happy. Just be happy. That's exactly what I heard a loving sister tell her adorable brother at his bar mitzvah. That was her message to him. I'm sure she meant exactly that. Just be happy. Just be happy? Is that all that is important in life, that you are happy? What does that really mean? Hot fudge sundaes for breakfast every day would make me happy. And fat. How about hot fudge sundaes for breakfast, lunch, and dinner? That would make me fatter, but would that make me even happier? How about vacations? I love vacations. Can I just spend my life on vacations? Can I sleep in the saloon every day? Would that make me happy? Is the person who collects the most things in his life the happiest? I suggest that the answer to all these questions is a resounding no. So then what is it? What is the secret formula to living a truly happy life? I would like to propose that there are two types of happiness: short-term happiness and forever happiness. Getting a new bike, riding a roller coaster, going to Disney World, these all create short-term happiness. While you're experiencing the fun, you should be happy. But that happiness goes away shortly after the experience ends. What are the secrets to having a sense of happiness that literally stays with you forever? Because part of your DNA, to me, that is the definition of true happiness. I believe there are three secrets that will forever make your life a truly happier life. Secret number one, make other people happy, and you will be happy. Secret number two, be a giver, not a taker. The more you give, the happier you will be. And three, be proud of what you do, which will also make Hashem proud of you. What? Does it really make me happier to make someone else happy? Does it make me happier to give a present than to receive one? What does Hashem have to do with me being happy? Let me explain by giving you two examples. Example number one. Until 2 years ago, my son Jacob was a paratrooper in the Israeli army. He was also a volunteer for United Hatzalah, an amazing Israeli organization comprised of over 6,000 volunteers who are ready to run for medical emergency 24/7 in hopes to get there within 90 seconds to help the person in need. On his way home from the army one Thursday evening, while still in his army uniform, proudly wearing his kippah and exposed tzitzit, with his machine gun by his side, Jacob sat by the local makolot, the grocery store, to buy some food for Shabbat. While there, he noticed an older woman whose leg was bleeding. He mentioned to her that he saw that her leg was wounded and wondered if he could clean the wound and bandage it. Of course, the woman said, sure. Jacob ran home to get his first aid kit and ran back to clean the woman's wound and bandage it. After doing this, he asked the woman who she was. She was a Christian woman who was on a cruise and stopped in Israel for one day to tour Yerushalayim. On Yerushalayim's cobblestone streets, she tripped and scraped her knee. Although I'm sure this Christian tourist was very moved that a soldier with a machine gun cared enough about her that he ran home to get a first aid kit to bandage her knee, what a kiddush Hashem for Jacob to do this. Example number two. Our dear friend Danny Agan tomorrow, literally tomorrow in New York City, will donate one of his kidneys to a MASH who is a complete stranger to him. How amazing is that? It's not a simple procedure, it is in fact a painful procedure. It also can perhaps create some risk for Danny, for the rest of Danny's God willing long life. Both of these examples show all three elements of living a happy life. Yes, helping another person who fell, and yes, even donating a kidney will make you happy. No parents are not suggesting you sign up your eighth graders to donate their kidneys tonight. In both cases, the giver is the forever happy one. In both cases, one person made the other person happy, and in both cases, certainly Hashem was smiling in appreciation for the chesed done. My dear eighth graders, you can see through both these examples that true happiness is not created by getting more things in life. True forever happiness is created by giving. Giving of your time, giving of your resources, giving of your neshama. And in this process, both you and Hashem are happy. This is called chesed. Things come and go in your life, but true acts of chesed will stay with you forever. I promise you, the more chesed you perform in your life, the happier you will be. So when your sibling has his or her bar bat mitzvah, don't just wish them to be happy. Wish them the ability to make others happy, to be a giver in life, not a taker, and to always do things that make them proud of their actions. And when this happens, Hashem will be right there with them, as being a giver of chesed will enable them to live a happy life. My dear eighth graders, I'm so proud of each of you for getting to this memorable day in your lives. The best is truly yet to come. My bracha for each of you is to live a meaningful life, a life filled with the happiness, by doing acts of chesed, as I guarantee you that if you live a life filled with doing acts of chesed, you will live a happy life. As a Kohen, I feel honored to always end with the same wonderful bracha that we just read a few weeks ago in Parshat Naso. Yerecha adonai v'shmerecha, Yair adonai v'panav v'lech v'necha, Yisa adonai v'panav v'lech v'lesem v'lech v'shalom. Thank you.
Okay, next I call upon the yearbook editors to come up and speak. Eitan Landau is unavailable right now, so he is one of the editors as well. Okay, editors are Rebecca Friedman, Lily Harrow, Tamara Gantz, Ariella Mayer, and Eitan Landau.
Social distancing, cohorts, contact tracing, and more. Trips, programs, and events had to be modified, but flexibility ruled and we were able to have an amazing academic and fun-filled year. With the tireless efforts of our awesome heroes, we were able to have a smooth and safe transition into this new normal. We learned that not all heroes wear capes and that ordinary people can do extraordinary things. We hope that we can learn to emulate these selfish role models and become the best people we can be.
Over the course of our many years at Katz Hillel Day School, we have had the most memorable experiences. Each and every year, we are blessed to have an excellent education along with many wonderful experiences to enhance and enrich the quality education that was transmitted to us. We cannot express how much we will miss KHDS as we embark on our high school journey. We will carry the values that our devoted and dedicated teachers have instilled in us for the rest of our lives. We will continue to grow in our Torah learning and apply the lessons we gleaned in all of our subjects to our daily lives. Our Hillel family has been so nurturing and supportive, and for that we will be eternally grateful. Yeah.
Although our much-anticipated Israel trip has been swiped from us by the COVID-19 pandemic, we are so appreciative to our educators who have done their absolute best to provide us with a fun and meaningful year. We feel so much gratitude to Hashem for keeping us healthy and allowing us to learn together in our beloved school. Even though we can see mere pieces of Hashem's puzzle, we must believe that everything Hashem does is for a reason, and that one day we will be able to see the complete picture. This message was ingrained in us at KHDS, and it is a lesson that will serve us well throughout our lives.
To our dear classmates and peers, it has been such an honor to have studied by your side all these years. You've truly enhanced our school experience and made it so worthwhile. From class jokes to color lore, all the way to our very own 8th grade graduation. We are fortunate to have experienced all of this together. May we all go on to do wonderful things and continue to support each other in whatever life will bring. In producing this yearbook, much gratitude goes to the following people who volunteered time and effort during this most challenging COVID year. Thank you to Mrs. Caroline Katz for photographing the kindergarten and eighth grade graduates. The pictures were breathtaking. Thanks to Mrs. Jill Kamenetsky, Mrs. Rena Kahn, Mrs. Suzanne Rice, Mrs. Marjorie Tenio, Mrs. Stacey Kaner for helping with the editing. Thank thank you to Rabbi Smolarsik for helping with the technological issues that constantly arose. A special thank you to Maura Dasa, who worked endless hours to ensure that we could have our yearbook this year. We are so appreciative. We are so appreciative of your guidance and leadership. You've been with us as we've navigated our lower and middle school. Also, thank you to our head of school, Rabbi Kotok, who has worked so hard during these last years as middle schoolers. We wish you much hatzlacha in your next endeavor. To Maura Lanner, thank you for the investment made in our learning experience and for always being there for us. Thank you to Mr. Klein Diamond for the formative years that began shaping us as KHDS students. Afron, afron, chavibi. To all our teachers in Irvine for understanding the level of difficulty this year has brought in us and for helping us get through it. Most importantly, we want to express our hakar hatov for teaching and inspiring us through our years at KHDS and for celebrating with us today as we move into the next chapter of our lives.
Now to outline our PTA president, Ms. Rachel Harrow, who's going to share with you all about this.
Ari the Lion and drinking fountains to faculty and staff, so they felt appreciated and excited to be a part of our KHDS family. Throughout the years, PTA has been able to raise and invest over $500,000 into the school. And from the little things to the what you have. From the little things to the large expenditures, this has all been done for you, so that you graduates will look back on your time at KHDS family, cherishing the lessons you learned, the experiences you gained, and the relationships you forged. As a final token of our love, we are sending each of you on with a new CDOR. We hope that you will value this gift, use it in health and happiness, much simcha and rachov, and that Hashem will always hear your tefillot.
Amen. Everyone, please give their attention now to the big screen in the back for our students' KHDS Journey video.
Oh, favorite thing about KACS is how warm and welcoming everyone is there. Because in just 2 years, I made a lot of new friends and learned a lot of new things.
My favorite subject in Katz Day School was Lamash because Maura Lanner helped me feel more connected and have a stronger relationship with Hashem.
Katzel Day School has taught me to love Torah, Mitzvot, and Eretz Yisrael. I've had such great teachers and rabbis who helped and supported me along the way. I also made great friends. Thank you, KHDS.
KHDS Color War was a lot of fun because even though we may have been on separate teams, me and my friends were still friends throughout the whole competition. And it was just very friendly and relaxed overall.
Castle Day School is a great school, and has taught me so much educationally and spiritually. I have learned many great skills that I plan to use throughout my life. I learned how to improve my connection to anything I care about. Thank you to all my friends and teachers for making this a great year.
One of my favorite parts of Castle Day School was Color War, because Color War was a really fun experience overall, and I had a great time with friends, and all the activities were amazing.
My favorite memory at Katz Hillel Day School was having my dad as my 7th grade dance teacher, and also I had to mention him because 2 siblings of mine forgot to, and I like singing candy from the song. I also have to mention one other teacher. He's put up with me for a long time. This teacher taught me Tosh Bun 6th grade, Makerspace, and the Robotics Club. This teacher, of course, is Rabbi Smith. Thank you, Rabbi Smith.
I have been in KHDS since EC3. I'm leaving KHDS with amazing friends, great memories, and rabbis that I respect and admire. Thank you so much, KHDS.
Camp because it was a great bonding experience with my friends and I got to see everyone's fun personalities outside of school.
Faculty at Katz Hillel Day School are amazing and help us succeed.
My favorite memory at KHDS is playing in the basketball game with all my friends and having fun in the sports program. Thank you, KHDS.
I will fondly remember the friendships that I've made while at Katz Hillel Day School. My experiences with my friends and the faculty of KHDS will always be a part of me.
I love KHDS so much because it's where I've grown up. The staff administration are all so kind and caring, and each of them have taught me such important lessons that I will never forget. With my peers and fellow classmates, I've made such great memories that I will forever cherish. I love KHDS, and there's nowhere else I'd rather call my second home.
Favorite subject in Katz Hillel Day School is 7th grade because it memorizes with great teacher. Also, like Coach Warner's trip, being taught in the soccer.
My favorite Katz Hillel Day School memory is Color War because I got to hang out with people that I usually wouldn't spend as much time with. Also, Color War offered us the opportunity to get together, have fun, and be creative.
I'm thankful for the KHDS sports program that taught me how to be a better teammate and to be closer to my friends.
Throughout my years in middle school, I've had the privilege of experiencing 3 amazing Color Wars. Color War has been my opportunity not only to bond with friends, but also to make connections and friendships to others outside my grade. This year, having been a Color War captain, I have had the ability to sharpen my leadership skills and show the importance of unity.
My favorite subject at Katz Day School was math, because I love to learn new ways to solve problems.
My Katz Day School Judaic Studies education has taught me I'm not and to strive to grow closer to Hashem, because even though the hardships this year were really difficult on all of us, we must remember that Hashem is doing what's best for us. I've grown so much in my spirituality due to my experience at Katz.
My favorite Katz Day School memory is when I moved here in 7th grade and having the most amazing friends who guided me and cared for me throughout the entire year. Thank you, KHDS!
Color at Katz Day School was amazing. It was something that felt normal in a year full of COVID. It was a great time for me and my friends to make memories that will last forever in our last year of Katz Day
School. My favorite Katz Day School experience is Color. Everyone works together to win. I love the banner ideas, the smart song ideas, and the friendships I've made throughout Color. It's my two favorite days of the year.
Best because I got to take a break from learning, had a good time with my friends, and the events and activities were fun and well planned.
One of the highlights of my KHS experience was Rabbi Ksorlin's social studies class. Rabbi Ksorlin has the ability to transform boring and obscure ideas such as anyone, voodoo, economics, into fun and exciting concepts. His energy and enthusiasm lights up the classroom and makes learning fun and exciting.
My favorite part of Katz Day School was all of the memories. It was laughing and meeting up with my friends. I love them so much and would not be here without them. I truly feel like new friendships that last a lifetime.
My favorite subject at Katz Day School is makerspace, because it teaches you very important skills and lessons you will need to know for the future.
Ever since EC2, my Katz Day School experience has been amazing because I've had family, friends, and teachers who have helped and guided me throughout my years.
Was our recent trip to Simon Tilly. I had such a fun time and I look forward to sharing so many more incredible memories with my friends next year. Thank you so much, Katz Day School, for this amazing opportunity.
Oh, I love you, Ariella!
Coming where at HDS is an amazing experience because it allows each student to explore and develop each of their own interests and abilities while also maintaining a sense of togetherness and teamwork.
Color at KHDS was an amazing experience because I learned about toughness, teamwork, and having a lot of fun. I'd like to thank Laura and Asa, Rabbi Potok, and all of my teachers for making these past 3 years so enjoyable and educational. Thank you.
My favorite part about KHDS is all the fun activities that the teachers set up. Even during Corona, they make sure that we're always having fun.
I think that my favorite class throughout my KHDS experience would have to be social studies, particularly in middle school. In 6th grade, I learned that I had this passion for debate. In 7th grade, I learned about the American political system and why America works. This past year, I learned about our nation's history. All of this helped me organize my thoughts in a coherent and persuasive way. Going into high school, not only will this help me academically, but I also think it will help me make a difference in my community.
My favorite class at KHDS is math, because they make it fun and easy to learn math. I also really enjoy the sports, because they help me get into a lot of sports programs I can enjoy with my friends.
My favorite Katz Day School experience was the trips, because it gave me time to bond with my friends.
One of the things that I enjoyed most about Katz Day School was
think and build and just have fun with my friends.
Hello, RKHDS has been the highlight of my year for the past 3 years because it brings all the grades together and it creates a special bond with one another. It is so much fun and a great experience.
Teachers and KHDS are amazing because they always go out of their way to make sure that we understand. understand the material. They also make learning fun and exciting to learn.
I love cheering with my friends, and because I cheer so loud, I lost my voice.
My memory from Katz Holidays was our pigeon key trip in sixth grade. I really enjoyed getting to snorkeling with my friends, and going on a boat and seeing sharks, and spending the night with them, and it was a really fun memory, and I'm thankful that I got to have it.
My friends at Katz Hill are also, because they're all caring and look out for each other.
My friends at Katz Hill Day School are amazing because they are friendly and nice.
My favorite experience at Katz Hill Day School was the challenge arm because I got out of the way for a moment and had a lot of fun.
I'm so grateful for the friends I've made over the past 8 years in KHDS. They're really always there for me, especially this year during Corona. We've had so many great experiences and memories, and I can't wait to be friends with them for the rest of life.
My favorite subject at Katz Hill Day School is PE, because I got to play sports with my friends. I had no homework, and it taught me good sportsmanship and teamwork, which are skills I will use for the rest of my life.
They tell you that you're too small to make a difference. They tell you that you're too weak to go the distance. But take the first step and you'll see that you can go far. They tell you that you're too long to be inspired. They tell you that you're too short to reach up higher. Trust in yourself.
Larson for putting that beautiful montage together. And now, we've all been waiting for the presentation of the diplomas. I would ask that Ms. Maradasa, Marlatter, and Mr. Katz please come forward.
Gabriella Asher. Naomi Hike. Rottenberg. Maya Saka. Rachel Shimanovich. Rebecca Schlesinger. Gilad Aron. Ah. Jaime Froland. Yeah. Yes, Gabrielle Seidel. Moshe Aaron Seinfeld. Benjamin Sheinberg.
So as we're living celebration, before we have the grand finale here, it's true tradition also to realize that we're not fully complete. As with weddings where we break the glass, Israel recently has not had the easiest time. And I want us to take a moment of quiet, a moment of thought, to realize where we really should be right now in Eretz Israel. Eighth graders, we will definitely miss your energy and enthusiasm. Know that KTS will always be your home. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my proud honor present to you the newest members of our alumni ranks, the Katz Hillel Day School Class of 2021. Mazel tov to our graduates.